We'll go ahead and get started. This is a 115 session on what you need to know about a small business server solution. We'll go ahead and get started. My name is Ryan Elledge. I'm the Chief Operating Officer for Overland Park headquartered Codero. And I'll give you a brief introduction to Codero as well as my background in the hosting industry. And then we'll jump into this presentation. I moved out to Kansas City in 1999. Can you guys hear? Because I can't tell if this is hardly even working. I moved out to Kansas City in 1999 to work for a local startup, Communitech.net, which was a shared web hosting provider founded in 1997. I was actually a client of Communitech.net, and I complained enough that they offered me a job to come out here and fix it, since I seemed to know how to do it so much better. So I moved out here as a high school baseball coach. That was my introduction into web hosting. I hosted my baseball team's website. I hosted my baseball team's website with Communitech. And like I said, I complained a lot, so moved out here as the director of support. And then they later promoted me shortly thereafter to the director of operations. Communitech sold in 2002 to a publicly traded company called Interland, which is it's now called web.com. It's one of the few web hosting companies that's actually publicly traded today. Rackspace is the most recent one, and they're more of an enterprise level. Communitech, and it was shared hosting. After I left there, I started working still with web hosting companies, but kind of on the other side. Founder and part owner of and the chief executive officer of a local company here in Kansas City called iNet Interactive. And we went out and bought up a bunch of technology websites and consolidated them. If you're a developer, you've probably heard of hotscripts.com. That was one of our sites. In the hosting industry, we had webhostingtalk.com, which is a very well-known website in the hosting industry. We sold that business, and then shortly thereafter, I was brought in to be the chief operating officer for A+.net, which was a San Diego-based, one of the oldest and largest in the United States web hosting companies. And being headquartered in San Diego, it's a very expensive place to do business. We moved that company here to Overland Park in the Kansas City area. Just August, so like 2-3 months ago, we sold the brand A+.net and all of our shared hosting assets to a competitor of ours named Hostopia. They're a Canadian-based company. But we kept the dedicated server and managed services business, and we had to create a new brand, and that brand is Codero, which is probably why you've probably never heard of it. The name's only been around for the last couple of months, but we're the same company that's been around since 1994 in the same industry. So that's a little background on Codero and myself. Today, Codero, we're headquartered, like I said, in Overland Park. We have about 6,000 and some servers under management. We have two data centers, one in San Diego, California, and one in Phoenix, Arizona. We do not have a local Kansas City data center. Looked hard and had a hard time finding enough floor space for us to build out here. Excuse me. So enough background. Today I want to talk to you about some of the issues facing small businesses from an IT perspective and what companies like Codero. I'm not here to pitch Codero. I've sat in many a conference, and this is not a sales pitch for Codero by any means. Just more of a talk discussion about the industry, the shared and managed and dedicated hosting industry. There's a lot of IT issues facing small businesses today. We're in a rough economy, as everybody knows, and businesses are driving more and more of their businesses online, and websites become very integral to a company succeeding. Some companies will shut their actual doorstep before they'll shut down their website and go out of business because the costs are so significantly less. But with the evolving necessity to be online, there's a lot of issues that small businesses in particular face because they don't have the technical resources and knowledge to be able to adequately manage their online business. Traffic increases to their websites, the complexity increases for their websites. They have to understand DNS records and how to manage those DNS records. There's never-ending updates, not only to their website themselves, but to the software that's running it, the operating systems. Data loss, very important factor. You know, my mom learned about data loss the hard way. She had probably 10,000 digital pictures on her computer and 5 years of tax returns for all the people. She was an accountant that she did, and she didn't have proper backups. Well, in the real world, with websites, data backup is a potentially costly but very necessary evil for businesses to have. Security threats. The online industry, you all hear about the various viruses, the Conficker virus, everything going out. There's a lot of really smart people in this world that do nothing but try to disrupt the lives of other people and take businesses down. And security threats are a very big issue for people with websites online. Just last year, the Open Security Foundation added over 11,000 new vulnerabilities to its database. That's in 1 year. And businesses have to be able to keep up with those things. And then there's the actual cost of the infrastructure it takes to host their infrastructure. A lot of small businesses try to just use their DSL line or whatever is provided to them from their internet service provider, keep servers in-house. But that becomes a challenge, because as your business relies more and more on its website, if that website's not up, your business will suffer. As we reach these Christmas shopping seasons coming up, which is when a very significant increase in online buying takes place, it's important for businesses to keep their websites up. We're going to talk a little bit about server management solutions and what options these small businesses have. A business owner can choose to get the equipment out of their office or their home, for that matter, and they can use co-location. Co-location is where they put their equipment in somebody else's facility, but they own it, they have to operate it, they have to manage it, they have to take care of all of those things we just discussed on the previous slide. The nice thing, one of the pros about co-location, is you actually own the hardware that you're putting in, and you don't have to build out that infrastructure to keep your websites online. You can take advantage of other people spending a high amount of money to do such. A negative thing to co-location is it's not your environment. You still are responsible for the maintenance. That server hard drive fails, you have to be the one that goes and replace it or have staff to do so. Dedicated server hosting, which is one of the product offerings that Codero has. This is where you put your website and applications on servers that we own, and we're responsible for fixing them if they fail. But everything that's running on the server is in your control. So you still have to have the knowledge of patching the OS when there's new updates that come out. DNS management, email management, all of that still relies on your in-house expertise and knowledge.